fana elo achi kaje mano popole me mwaga kwosha omura achi matogwa ya ufovu fana mao kwa flaga da.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Politically Correct Ghana lesson 37. I'm just in my garden and just thinking, something just occurred to me. How much do you pay the cocoa farmer? And so today is Politically Correct Ghana lesson 37, and the title is Geoeconomics of Cocoa Ghana. The Ghanaian cocoa farmer gets paid 660 cedis per bag, that is 62.5 kg. You need 16 of those bags to make a ton. And the law says that, look, it's only cocoa board that is in charge of determining the price of cocoa to the farm gate at the farm gate in Ghana. Ivory Coast also pays about the same amount when you convert it, 660 cedis per bag. That is 62.5 kg bag of cocoa. Then you go on to find out how much is Nigeria paying. Nigeria is paying at the farm gate 849 cedis per bag of cocoa. That's the same 62.5 kg. Brazil is also paying 849 thereabout cedis per bag when you convert the currencies. So why is Ghana paying that low? Why is Ghana that paying? Then you go on to check on the international market. Who are the markets? That's the New York Mercantile Market that buys cocoa from Asia. Then we have the Intercontinental Exchange, that's ICE in London, that buys from Africa. So if Nigeria and Ghana and Ivory Coast cocoa is bought by ICE, then if you suppose that the amount we're giving our farmers needs to be looked at. If it needs to be looked at, what does the law say? The law says only cocoa board determines the farm gate price in Ghana. And that monopoly is what has been broken. That's PNDC law 81 has to be changed to reflect the modern times, reflect the liberalized market that we are experiencing in Ghana. So that law must change. And then the cocoa board monopoly broken up. Once we break out that monopoly, then of course there will be competition. With competition, prices might hike for the farmers. The farmers are likely to get something better. The second aspect, which is immediately, I would think, and I'll suggest, second suggestion or recommendation, the government of Ghana must quickly increase the price of cocoa at the farm gate from 660 cedis to 840 cedis for the cocoa farmers. That way, there is some form of equity, there is some benefit of being a cocoa farmer. In the absence of that, the cocoa farmers keep tilling the soil, the land, they own the land, they own the tools that belongs to them. Meanwhile, you pay them about 51% of what you sell. And Nigeria pays about 80%. Brazil pays about 100%. Give all at the farm gates to the farmers. So the cocoa farmers in Brazil and Nigeria do better than those of Ghana and Ivory Coast. We want more cocoa because we are the leading producers, Ivory Coast and Ghana, yet we're paying less. What kind of mathematics is this? We have to pay them about 80% and sometimes 100%, just like Brazil is doing. In Brazil, they pay about 80% or 100%. This percentage is between the farm gate and the global price, So meanwhile, Ghana is paying 51-52% between the farm gate price and the global price of cocoa. This, I'm not sure is right. It's not ethical. Ethics must take charge of what we do. The name is H. Kwame Afagro. Thank you.